We have a real treat in store for you right now as meteorologist Alexander Williams joins us to talk us through a science experiment that's perfect for rainy weather. And, you know, spring often brings that rainy weather. So we do have to give a shout out to STEM Laboratory, that blog. That's where we got the idea for this. Alexander, tell us, how are we going to make it rain?
Well, we're not going to make it rain in studio, but we are going to actually make it rain. We're going to make our own rain cloud out of shaving cream, and then we're going to use food coloring to make it actually rain.
I love it.
A really easy experiment for you and your family to do, really easy things to find around the house. If, you know, shaving cream, of course, obviously is one of those. You need food coloring, some water. The water needs to be cold or cooler water.
Okay.
That's what we filled our jugs with here. You need a jar that's not on there, but you need something to put it in, you know, unless you're doing it on a plate or whatever. But you can see our mason jar here.
Yeah.
Yes. So this is cool water. You fill it 3/4 with cool water.
Okay.
And then we're going to take our shaving cream and no, we're not actually going to shave.
I thought you were.
We're going to create our cloud.
Okay.
Okay.
Okay, so you're filling us up. Great. Thank
making
you.
Our clouds, right? Because we have to form the clouds before we have rain.
Okay, that makes sense.
Part of the water
cycle. That's a great tip for you guys at home, especially now with spring break. Parents, this is a good educational lesson for your kiddos. You need the clouds before the rain.
That's right.
Absolutely. Got to make the clouds. And in the atmosphere, we need clouds, of course, to get rain.
Yeah.
All right. So once you make your cloud, your shaving cream clouds, then we're going to make it rain. So here's the fun part. So we're going to take a pipette. That was one of the other things I didn't mention. You need something to be able to squeeze it with, whether it's an eyedropper, whether it's a pipette, something like that. And we're going to use our food coloring that we made. So we did blue, but you can do any type of rain. You can make green rain. You can make yellow rain. You can make
purple rain.
Yes, please.
Yes, absolutely. And then you're just going to drop it on top of your cloud. And I'm going to make a mess here. The cloud's going over the side of the jar. But we're going to keep doing this. If you see a place that's sinking, it's kind of a good place to add it. So there's your pro tip. But what's going to eventually happen is we're going to make a mess all over the table, which is all part of science,
right?
That's right. We want to do that.
Science is
messy sometimes.
So you're
going to keep adding it, and we're going to watch the bottom of the jar, because eventually we're going to saturate this entire column of shaving cream here. I might have made it a little too thick. And you'll start to see at the bottom some of our food coloring starting to come out in the bottom of the cloud. And that's the same thing that happens in the atmosphere. So you actually need 100% saturation of the atmosphere for the rain to reach the ground. Otherwise, you start to get a little bit of our gray. Anybody seen any blue? Oh, Jason's got a little
Mine's
bit there. Jackie's
a little bit,
starting to come through, starting to reach 100% saturation here.
Nice.
My atmosphere is taking a little bit longer to saturate. But you'll start to see it come out the bottom first, and it doesn't quite reach the bottom because we haven't saturated the whole solution. So hopefully we can start to get it to rain here with our pipettes. We probably could have just
used... I'm so close.
There's a little bit blue. Okay, so there you go. If you look at the very, very top of our jars, you can see the blue starting to fall. And the more you're going to add, the more we'll start to see it kind of mix down through the solution. We got a big jar here. We're really saturating our clouds. And so that would be called what we in the atmosphere, virga. So that's rain that's not reaching the ground. It's evaporating because the atmosphere is not 100% saturated. So this is a really cool science experiment that we can just make it rain here. Hopefully, it'll start to rain.
Like parents, don't worry. We really didn't get that messy at
home. That's true.
So again, we got a list of things that you'll need: some shaving cream, pipette,
just as you
a
said
jar,
that.
Some food coloring, and some cool or cold water.
I feel like I'm making it mist more than I'm making it
rain.
Yeah,
we're going to keep
right?
working on this. I love this, Alexander.
Absolutely.
We'll show you a finished product where it actually starts to rain, you know, when we get saturation.
Yeah. Alex, thanks for bringing this experiment to us. It's always so fun to have you on the show and in studio with us.
Always enjoy being with you guys. And hopefully we can make it rain soon. Oh, there's a little bit of rain.
Keep working on
here we go, the center one.
Oh,
we got raindrops.
Yes.
We had saturation.
That's right.